Yeah, we do.
Love you too.
I guess the first question, what was it like watching the audience tonight?
You want to go first? No, I can go first. Right, should I go first? I'll go first. That was very surreal watching yourself a quarter of a century ago, you know? Which, you know, and the last time I saw it like that was with Pearl, and we were sitting right at the front at the Leicester Square Odeon, but it was like, with Billy McKenzie, you know, rest in peace. But it was like 90 foot high, so it was very strange.
So your neck's craned a little bit.
Yeah, but it was good. I mean, just, you know, reminds me that we all had a lot more hair except Robert.
So originally this was like a tour for the singles collection, standing by the sea and all. Staring at the sea, I'm sorry, and standing on the beach.
Right? If you say so.
Yeah. Head on the Door came out, and then there was the singles collection after. So this was a tour based around that. Was the idea that you wanted to do a live concert for home video and maybe theatrical?
Yeah, we definitely wanted to do a theatrical.
Yeah.
It was, because we finally found somebody that resonated with us to make, you know, like a team to make a movie. And the band was really good at the time, right?
Yeah, I think
it was one of the best. Yeah, so it was like, and just after that, we went to Kiss Me, and we went on a vacation, didn't we? We had a band vacation down by the sea and stuff. So this was like our last piece of, you know, real, real.
Tim was very much part of it.
Right.
At that time with the band as well. There was a camaraderie that just wanted to continue for something.
Hey, Pearl, you might want to talk more directly to Mike. Yeah, because I want to make sure people hear what you're saying. No one cares about what I'm saying, but they definitely care
about what you're saying. Yeah. But it was like our last piece of work to do before we had a holiday, you know, so we enjoyed doing it.
Was the location always like set down, like this is where we definitely want to shoot it?
I think so, yeah.
Yeah, because... Right, the kid always, we always liked to play in places that were unusual, you know, if we could, you know, and at the time, we had like four albums in the top 40 in Paris, you know, Mitterrand gave us an invitation to come and meet him at the Elysee Palace, so we could do anything we want, so we went, okay, we want to play in this old Roman amphitheater that you haven't ever let anybody play in, you know, they went, okay.
I mean, it, part of what makes the concert so much more brilliant is that location, because it's, I mean, let's not deny it, it's fucking epic. Yeah. But, with the location, how many days did you film?
I think it was two.
Yeah, it was two, because We filmed the day with the concert, which, you know, it's in the middle of August, so it was really nice. That's actually the thing that I, looking at it, it felt really hot, you know, because it was really hot. And then we just left everything up and we came in the next day and filmed again with our audience, you know. So we could get those crazy, like, wasn't Give Me It absolutely insane?
Yeah.
No, I mean, it was, you know, those sort of weird shots with the camera flying about and stuff. You know, we would have decapitated a couple of members of the audience if we'd done it with them in there, so, you know, it's much safer to do it without.
So, when this movie came out, because it came out theatrical before it hit home video, do you remember how wide of a release it had?
I think it was just like, you know, every other Thursday at midnight, you know, for a couple of days, you know, it didn't go like, you know, for weeks and weeks everywhere. It's minimal theatrical release.
Okay. Because it was primarily for home video purposes.
Right? Yeah, straight to home VHS and Laserdisc. Who remembers Laserdisc?
We're at the Cinematheque. Everyone here remembers Laserdisc. So, as a lot of people here know, this has never had a release outside of VHS and Laserdisc. And as we said in the introduction, this might be the only print that's left.
Except for the one that Pearl's got at home, right? I have a copy of Carnage on it. I have a, yeah, I have a reel of that somewhere. Yeah. It's in my garage. Yeah.
So, besides looking, what were your thoughts on this tour, since it was more the singles collection, a little bit ahead of the head on the door?
I don't know that really we had any other thoughts other than we were on the road again. You know, we've been on the road for about a million years at that point. So, yeah. I mean, I think what we were saying on the way down here, that it was the best version of the band that we'd had at the time. Because, you know, the Cure to me has two different bands. It was a three-piece that was, you know, me and Robert and Simon. And then there's this sort of, what I understand is called the Imperial Cure by some fans, which I have no idea what that means at all. But anyway, that's with Pearl and Boris. So it was a good version of the band, you know, and we were just very happy about it.
So moving forward after that, like, you moved on to, I guess, Kiss Me after that, correct?
Right. I mean, that was really the whole point of us being in France. We were going to finish that. We'd already done some demos for that before. Yeah. We were going to finish that and go
80 songs.
Yeah, we had a lot of songs. So it was just a very fertile period, you know. And then we went on to Toulon, where we thought we would have a nice vacation. We thought nobody would be there. In fact, you know, half of France followed us there. So we didn't really have a vacation as such. People hiding behind sand dunes. And then we went to dragging on with Jean Costa, who was the sax player, the musical director of Johnny Halliday's band. You know, Johnny Halliday is the French Elvis. He's still going now. I mean, he's like 850 years old, but he's still going. And
he was like a megastar in France.
Yeah, yeah. So, you know, we only had the best. And then we went on to Chateau Mirabel, which I think now was Brad Pitt's man. Yeah. Yeah. And I sent a picture the other day. I sent a picture because they sell Chateau Mirabel in Whole Foods, right? And I sent a picture to Robert and Simon, and they said, you remember this? And Simon said, yeah, I still remember how it tasted like gasoline. You know, because it's the most horrible wine, I have to tell you that. I'm sure they've got it in a much nicer bottle now, but it's but we drank a lot of that, yeah.
So I guess, closing thoughts on this tour and this era of the band for you guys.
It was just a fun period. We all got along really well. You can tell just by the way we played together.
Yeah, like I always say, and Paul's right, we got along really well. The Cure is like a family with all that stuff. You know, it's always been like that. So it's, you know, that was one of the best times for the family of the Cure.
And I agree. Like, when you watch the film, you guys are definitely having fun. It's, I mean, like I said in the beginning, immerse yourself in the experience, because that's the experience. Because, like, there's concert films, and then there's this, which allows you to kind of, like, be part of the show.
Yeah, we liked it because of that, and we also, we'd watched, you know, Pink Floyd live in Pompeii. Yeah. You know, this is like live in Pompeii, but with an audience, you know, and we played Set the Controls for Heart of the Sun, didn't we, in soundcheck, I remember that, yeah. It was pretty good.
So Lol, in case everyone doesn't hear, you have a book that just came out.
Yeah, a little while ago. Yeah, called Cured. Thank you. Thank you very much. Paul was gracious enough to design the cover, so probably a good time to tell you that me and him are actually going to do a graphic novel together.
Yeah. So
that's in the works. Actually, my publisher's here, so that's probably news to him. But there you go, Ben. Yeah. Yeah, so I had a book out because it was just like the story of everything, you know, because I'd always wanted to write, and last year seemed like the perfect time to do it.
You're also working on a second book, right?
Yeah, besides the novel, there's a second book, so I'm a busy boy at the moment. You know. I'm also working on a radio show, which you're going to hear about soon. It's called Antimatter,
yeah.
So listen out for that.
Oh, awesome.
You didn't know that, did you? Yeah, well, you're going to be a guest on it. So. Yeah, it'll be fun.
And Pearl, you've been focusing on your art, correct?
Yeah, mostly.
Because I think Lethal Mass a few months ago, because that's where I saw both of you guys at, was like you had your art on display, which was really, really cool. Are you doing more gallery shows?
Well, I've just moved studio location, so I'm rebuilding a new collection and going to put it online soon, hopefully. Yeah.
Cool.
Yeah, and still doing music. We've been doing some music together.
Whoa.
That's how we do that. We can make a sort of audio accompaniment to it as well.
Yeah, because I've seen on Instagram both you guys playing together. What's that like right now?
That was great. You know, it's funny because like we just like playing. Like I had a film soundtrack that I was doing. I asked Pearl to come and help me, and we just sort of started playing in my friend's studio, and it was like, oh yeah, I remember how you did this. It was like, you know, it was like riding a bike, really. You know. Just felt very natural.
That's what actually awesome here, because like when I saw like the videos and the photos, like that is the most heartwarming thing I've ever seen. It's nice to see when like people reconnect and like make music together. They made wonderful music together in the past, and it's a rarity, and it's really amazing to see that.
Thank you.
I'm going to give you guys, if there's anything else you want to talk about the film or in general, I'm going to open it up to the audience.
All right, Q&A, that's always fun.
And by the way, if you're asking a question, make it good. Don't be that guy or girl that doesn't ask a question and makes a statement. Make sure your questions matter.
Look at this film.
There's a short interval where it looks like the camera is attached to Smith's guitar and is moving around with him. How was that handled?
Well, I could tell you, I'd have to kill you. it's the same way as we did it in the video for it. You know, it's like attached to the guitar on this like thingy-me-jig. You know? So it looks like the whole thing moves at the same time. You know, it's just how we did it in the original video.
It was before Ghost. Cameras. Mm-hmm. Seriously, that camera was really heavy on those videos.
I'll get to your question. I wanted to ask, everything was shot in film, correct?
Yeah.
Absolutely.
Yeah. All right, go ahead, sir.
Have you talked to Robert about doing a second trilogy, since the first one that I got to see you play at was so fantastic, to see the next three albums that The Cure made?
Here's what I think about it. I'm open to anything, and you know, we're in the second part of our life. I think we can say that. We've probably got 20 or 30 years left, so it's time to do all those things. Yeah, I'm sure it will come to pass.
Guy in the back right there, stand up.
I read your book, and the question: how do you compare relationship like a marriage or family to living with a band, being on tour? Because I know you guys did thousands of shows. What is that like?
So the question was, how do I compare it to like a band, to being a marriage? It's pretty much the same thing in lots of ways. Sorry, honey, she's sitting up there, but except that when you're in a band, it's like you're probably together more, you know, like 24/7, you know, so you kind of really got to get on with each other. Otherwise, actually, the most sensible thing we ever did as a band was decide to have separate rooms. you just reminded. We used to have two buses, so we had the drink tea, sensible bus, read a book, and poles on that, and we had the crazy motherfuckers bus me, Robert, and Simon, and all that stuff. Yeah, but that was that's the sort of thing that keeps people together, you know, really, because we spent a lot of time. We spent two times. We did two 18-month back-to-back world tours, so you know, that's closer than the marriage. Yeah, lots of ways.
There's a gentleman right there that's waving his hand vigorously. Go.
How much would it cost to see you guys back at that same venue again?
He's asking how much would it cost to see you guys back at that venue again?
How much would it cost to see him back at that venue again? I don't know, name your price. No, I'll call Bob up and ask him.
So So basically, start your Kickstarter now.
Yeah.
All right. Right there.
Hey, so it sounded like pretty close to the record, like instrumentation-wise. So did you guys record it like live in the studio? Did you do a lot of multi-tracking? Like,
oh, they pulled poems. This
head
one.
On the door era?
Most of it is multi-tracked, but I think we pretty much, everybody was playing what they did live. Cool. Sometimes we'd swap around, like if Robert couldn't work on the guitar part and sing, I'd swap it over and then Lawrence would take over keyboards on some of the guitar parts. But generally we tried to keep it as was.
Yeah, I mean, you know, at that time, I don't think, apart from the revolts for a couple of songs for like 100 years, there was like a drum machine and pornography, there was like some sounds. Everything else we kind of played, you know, because that's the only thing we knew how to do. You know, it's not like nowadays where everybody has three or four computers and, you know, nobody's really playing. But we played it all, you know, however. Well or badly, it was playing. Sax was great. The sax was great. Like the sax.
All right, who's next? Right there.
Did you get an answer from Robert about our birthday video to him?
You know what? He hasn't, not yet. No, he's probably, well, it's 8 hours ahead, right? So yeah, he might be asleep. I mean, he's pretty nocturnal, so you know. Or he might just have seen it and thought, I don't think I should open this.
You've spoken previously about shooting on two different nights for this movie, and can you talk a little bit about the difference between having a full concert venue going and then all of a sudden you guys are just standing on stage doing your thing while they're trying to get close-ups, and the difference between that?
The difference between the first day where all the audience was in, the second day and nobody's in there except the crew. Yeah. I don't know, we were kind of used to it in that way because we've done videos a lot of the time and it's the same thing, you know.
And we enjoyed playing, so yeah. Just playing together on the stage is just as much fun. But you haven't got the opposite
from the
audience.
Plus, yeah, the other thing is that when there's so many people out there and you're on stage like that, the people that are closest to you are actually the people on the stage, so it doesn't really feel like, you know, it feels like it's a film going on out there most of the time. You know, when it's a smaller venue, people are right up here, that's much scarier. But when people are, like, you know, it's a bit like looking at a movie, so actually it wasn't really that different, you know.
Right there.
Right after the encore, can you come on after the encore? It looks like Robert gets hit with water. Was that like a fan or was that like a friend or what? Do you remember?
It was
a fan? And you were just super down with it?
I wasn't looking at that.
It's funny. I don't know.
Mind you, it could have been Tim Pope planted something to do.
Yeah, that was
like, you always try and wind him up somehow.
Yeah.
All right. Yeah. Right there, center. There.
When is this coming out on Blu-ray?
When is this coming out on Blu-ray?
When does it come out on Blu-ray? Well, I'll put that in the message. With the
So, question about Blu-ray, because this is the only, I think, film elements. It's definitely, Fiction Records was here tonight, they're taking a look at it. Hopefully they see something like it, that something can be made more fabulous. That's the scary thing about 35. Like, 35 looks beautiful, but it, like analog and like records and stuff, they can be worn out, they can be damaged, there can be scary moments where your leader catches fire. But, but right now, I think the discussion is going to be looking at this. So what you saw tonight might end up on your Blu-ray disc. No guarantee, but that's something to think about.
Hello.
Bob again.
Couldn't see any footage shot from stage right. Was there a camera over there that the film went bad or something? Was not usable?
Yes. I don't know about All I knew was Tim's out there filming, right? So,
right there.
Did
did you guys as a band usually shop together for clothes?
I used to go shopping with Pearl for shoes. In the strange shop on the streets of High Street. With a little window in the front. It didn't look like a shoe store to me, but yeah.
The suits that we're wearing on those was a friend of mine from art school. Mm-hmm.
John Flynn. Yeah, he made us like 25 suits. I still have one at home. Jeez. Yeah, so I found it the other day. I still have one. I'm trying to persuade my son, Gray, to wear all my old suits and stuff with his band, but he's not having it.
Right there.
Where do you think that you have the most fans? Like, is there a continent that supports you the most, or
she's asking, where do you think I have the most fans? Is like, what continent has the most Cure fans?
And also, do you have a favorite venue that you have played? Besides the that have played.
Or have played.
Yeah, I've played.
Yeah.
Well, you can say your first one.
Well, at that time, obviously, France was huge.
Yeah.
And it was ridiculous.
Yeah, France really is still pretty huge. For my book, I've been on tour for like the last 6 months. And the book was released in France a few months ago. And I went over there, and in Paris, there was as many people as there is here sitting in the theater, came to the bookstore, you know, just for a book signing, which is kind of unusual. So, yeah, France was pretty big, but California was definitely very huge. Yeah. It's one of the reasons I moved here, and the weather being the other reason. No, there's lots of reasons. Yeah, I think pretty much, you know, America and France were pretty much our biggest places.
All right, yeah. We're going to take two more right there.
Whatever happened to Robert's wig?
It had a family out in the south of this little Whig family living there. Right. Another one of Tim's ideas.
Before we take the last question, so you know, we're going to do this signing up here. Please don't bum rush us. We are only three mortal human beings.
Yeah, and I'm probably going to go off to the bathroom before you do any of that as well. So,
so we're going to bring a table up. Well, are you assigned to Pearl?
I'll pay for a little bit after.
Yes. Yeah. Okay, Pearl's going to sign Pearl. We're going to set the table up here. We're going to have everyone line up, starting where these gentlemen are. We're going to go up the